Say good morning. It's nice to see you. You are welcome to the presence of God. As we make welcome this morning, Father, in our midst, to bless us with the word of God for the next 20 minutes. Please, can we make welcome Pastor Olashene from RCCG? If you are clapping your hands, make it more resounding for God. Hallelujah.
We are clapping for the Lord, so we can do better than that. Come on, put your hands together for the Lord. It's a beautiful Wednesday morning. You slept, you woke up because the Lord sustained you. Come on, put your hands together. Put your hands together. It is not by power, it is not by might, but by my spirit, said the Lord. He made a roll call this morning and you go answer. Celebrate the Lord this morning. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. Lord, you are worthy. Blessed be your mighty name. Blessed be your mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name we worship. In Jesus' mighty name we worship. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Unto you alone we are gathered this morning. Father, fill us with the goodness of your presence. In the name of Jesus. Everyone within the reach of our voices this morning, Father, give them a divine encounter, Lord. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Joyfully take your seat. Good morning. Let me say good morning to your neighbor. Good morning, mommy and daddy in absentia. Thank you, ma, for this privilege once again this morning. The Lord will continue to honor you and lift you up, ma, in the name of Jesus. I've been asked to speak this morning about preparation. Above preparation. Now, let's not do English class, so I won't start to define what is preparation or what is above. The Bible says in Proverbs 16 verse 1, you say the preparation of the heart is in man, but the answer of the tongue will come from the Lord. The preparation of the heart is in man. But the answer of the thorn will come from God. It is man's job to prepare. God is not going to prepare for man. Where God needed to prepare, he did his own. You know, 1 Corinthians 2 verse 9. Bible says, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard what God has in stock, what he has prepared. So that's where God needed to prepare, and he has done that already. But as far as the matter of life and destiny is concerned, man needs to prepare. We must prepare. Jesus, in Luke 21, verse 18 to 20, sorry, Luke 14, 18 to 20, he says, who is that person who will want to build a house and you will not first sit down to count the cost, whether I'll have enough money to embark on this adventure? God is not going to do for us what we can do for ourselves. I repeat, God will not do for us what we can do for ourselves. For example, before we came in this morning, some people were here and are trying to put this place in order to ensure that the speakers will sound well, that the microphones will sound well, that the ambience will be good enough. God is not going to do that one. That is the responsibility of a man. Thank God a day with Jesus is around the corner. Praise the Lord. Are you excited? If you are excited, shout hallelujah. We are not sounding like we are excited. Now, God will not come down and do evangelism for us. Hello. He's not going to come down and share flyers. He's not going to come down and pack baskets. That is the job of man. So we have to prepare. We have to plan. We have to do logistics. But What do we need to do? Genesis chapter 1. The Bible says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and shape. The Spirit of the Lord moved over the face of the earth, and the Lord said, let there be light. And then immediately there was light. So beyond the preparation, beyond the logistics, beyond every other thing, we need the Spirit of the living God. Beyond all the excellence, beyond all the planning, beyond all everything, you want to go to school, you plan, you write jam, you write WAEC, you do all manner of things, you need the Spirit of the living God to succeed. The second thing that we need to do outside of preparation, Isaiah 30 verse 21. Bible says, whether you turn to the left or right, front or back, you are going to hear a voice behind you telling you that this is the way you should go. You need divine direction. If we must prevail in life, we need divine direction. Life is not a matter of guesswork. We need divine direction. There was a man in the book of Ruth. Elimelech was his name. He went to Moab to seek for bread. But he didn't live to tell the story. Please don't get me wrong. I'm not against people chaparing, you know. Hallelujah. But listen, did God tell you to do so? Let me ask your neighbor, did God tell you to do so? You need divine direction beyond all the preparation. Because if God is not leading us, see, you will pay for the transport fare yourself if God didn't send you. But if God is the one that is sending you there, he will go ahead and make every crooked path to be straight. He will make the provision. But if it is not God who is sending you there, you will provide the transport fare by yourself. That's why we need divine direction. We need his leading. The next thing that we need to do outside of preparation, we need consecration. Consecration. 1 Corinthians 6 verse 20. The Bible says, come out from among them and be ye separate. Come out. Consecration. Now, your consecration determines what you do. You cannot do what everybody is doing. You cannot dress the way everybody is dressing. You cannot talk the way everybody is talking. You cannot sing what everybody is singing. Consecration. So outside of the preparation that we prepare, we must consecrate ourselves. If God must speak to us, if God must lead us, we must consecrate. Devotion is key to our consecration. Are you devoted to your call? Are you devoted to your purpose? Are you devoted to that assignment that heaven has committed into your hands? You know, we may look sometimes listen, if that vision is given by God, then the only way out of it is to be devoted to that vision. Come rain, come sunshine, you are sold out onto that course. And that's why when a student gets into school, they go for classes, they do assignment, they do whatever, they do practicals, they do all sorts. Because without that, you will not be regarded to as a graduate or that you have passed. So the matter of destiny requires that we be devoted to our own course. The question is, what has God called me to do? What has God called you to do? You must identify your place in the body of Christ and stay there. Identify your place in the body of Christ and do what? And stay there. Everybody cannot hold microphone. Everybody cannot play the instrument. Everybody cannot arrange the chairs. But whichever place that heaven has placed you in the kingdom, zero in there. Because God is going to judge you not based on what you sent yourself or what I sent myself. God will judge us based on his own assessment of the things he has asked us to do. Hello? God will judge us not based on the way we feel, not the things we embark on by ourselves. He's going to judge us based on his own assessment. This is what I asked you to do. How did you do it? Devotion. Devotion. Another word that we need to look at beyond preparing for something or preparation is love. Love. When you love something, you are willing to pay any amount for it. True or false? Somebody talk to me. When you love something, you are willing to pay any amount to get it. True or false? It looks like I'm too far from us. I'm not getting the response I want. When KSA unction is jitter, Folawi, your son, was willing to pay 1.4 million naira to buy a jitter. And then people looked at it and said, doesn't know what to do with money. But listen, it's a function of value and love. Do I love God? Do you love God? You know, yesterday in church, I was asking a question jokingly, and I said, when we read the story of Abraham, how God asked him to go and sacrifice his son. Looks like a very good story. And then ask, your last card, the last money in your account. And God says, go and drop it for the church. Who will do it? It sounds very hard. But look at somebody, his only son. God said, go and kill him. No, sacrifice is a good choice of word. I mean, the best word is, God said you should kill him. Outside of preparation, we must love that cause. We must love. When you love someone, you go out of your way to satisfy that person. True of us. So, if I truly love a cause, I will go out of my way to make sure that I do everything to fulfill that cause. People of God, it is our responsibility to prepare. But it is God to give us direction. The Bible says that it is the honor of kings to conceal a thing. The secret things belong unto God, but the things that are revealed to us, they are for us and our children's children. We are the ones that will sack those things out. That's where our glory comes. But it is an honor for God to conceal those things. Have we not heard that gold is not found on the surface? So how much am I willing to pay? How much extra am I willing to do? What am I willing to do for the things that I want to get? And when I say how much am I willing to do, I'm not saying that anything that is not scriptural. They asked Rebecca, will you go with this man? Genesis 24. After they have kept her, she was old enough to go and marry. They are still asking her. Let's ask the young lady if she wants to go with you. Rebecca said, Emma Damiduro, let me go. Beloved, how much am I willing to pay? Who wants power? How many of us want power? You want power, power. Okay, everybody wants power. But are you willing to pay the price? Are you willing to pay the price? We must be ready. The elders have a saying, and to buy my jail, you know, a pattern. Go shaking. Could you wear no ake? We must be ready to go out of the way. What's our level of consecration? What's our level of devotion? You know, what's our level of love? What's our level of preparation for the things that we want to do? I trust God that from now, we will enjoy divine direction in the name of Jesus. Because we cannot continue to grope in darkness in life. When God is leading us, we will receive speed and accuracy. But when God is not leading us, we pay for the fare by ourselves, and it's painful. Shall we rise to our feet? I am willing, Lord. Please lead me in the path to go. Can someone talk to God this morning? Father, I am willing. Please lead me. Lead me in the path to go. I am willing, Lord. Please lead me in the path to go. I am willing, Lord. I am willing. I am willing. Please lead me in the path to go. Lead me in the path to go. People of God, Elimelech took a decision and it cost him his life. Please pray. I will not take a decision that will cost me my family. I will not take a decision that will endanger my family. Can you talk to God this morning? Lord, I will not take a decision that will endanger my family, that will endanger my own life. Somebody pray in the name of Jesus.
Go ahead, lift up your voice and pray a prayer that must be answered. In this race, I will not miss it. I want you to pray that prayer louder and clear, that the Lord will help you. After running the whole race here on earth, we will not miss heaven. In Jesus, please, and pray this morning. We want to pray for a day with Jesus. At the same time, I want you to first pray this prayer for yourself. We are praying for outpouring of miracles, signs, and wonders, testimony, divers. I want you to quickly pray this prayer, and then we'll convert it for a day with Jesus. Preparation have started long ago. We've started sharing flyers. The online advertisement is already on. Radio is already on. There have been many ways you have been doing the advertisement, both on status, on WhatsApp, on Facebook, every medium. Just like mommy wear our own t-shirt this morning, we have people that are already wearing the t-shirt for a day with Jesus, different design. Preparation. What can bring forth the glory of God is the Spirit of God. And you can't do without it. It doesn't matter how prepared are you. If the Spirit of God is not there, it is in vain. Can we lift up our voice and pray this morning? Say, my Father, my God.